Good morning, students. Warm welcome to today's online session. This online session mainly deals with the concept of virtualization. So, how virtualization impacts on CPU? And how virtualization concept impact on memory and input and output devices. So this we'll discuss in this class now. The topics to be covered in this lecture, online lecture, are hardware support for virtualization. What is virtualization? How hardware will support for this virtualization? And CPU virtualization, what is central processing unit virtualization? And what is mean by memory virtualization and how it will impact for virtualization concept? What are various input and output virtualizations? And virtualization impact on multi-core processors. These topics to be covered in this online lecture. Coming to the main points, why hardware virtualization is required? Why hardware virtualization is required? So, what is virtualization? Virtual is nothing but not actual. The meaning of virtual is not actual, something created virtual or new, not available in the market, that is called as a virtual. Virtual machine is nothing but, virtual machine is a server, a collection of servers which are keeping or kept in a single computer. So run two or more operating systems simultaneously at the same time is known as virtual machine. So virtualization is the environment providing in a cloud computing with the help of virtualization only. So here there are three key elements we are consider when selecting a hardware virtualization. Hardware virtualization is nothing but, so we need to consider three elements in hardware virtualization. Those are listed here: CPU, central processing unit, a memory is another virtual machine, and a network input output devices. These three are key elements which are considered in hardware virtualization. So virtualization means the system is working with a huge number of operating systems, huge number of data running at the same time with two or more different operating systems at the same time. So in this way, so the efficiency or the capacity of the virtualization computer can be mainly depends on the hardware virtualization. If the hardware virtualization is well familiar or is good or is well connected, then only we can able to deal large scale amount of operating systems or software or any applications we can deal in the market with the help of the hardware virtualization concept. So there are various critical for workload consolidation issues with the CPU cutting either clock speed or number of cores held by the CPU. So based on the CPU speed and based on the clock time speed, we can estimate that how effectively performed the hardware virtualization machine. Hardware virtualization basically allows us to run two or more different operating systems on a single unique machine. Here, this can be done due to a single software which can be installed over the operating system. That is called virtual machine manager. A virtual machine manager is a software which can be installed on the top of host operating system. Once the hardware components are well connected, so the hardware components are controlled by one host operating system. Once the host operating system installed in our computer on the top of host operating system, one software is installed for providing virtual environment. For creating virtualization, we need to install one software. That software is known as virtual machine manager. This virtual machine manager will provide an environment for creating hardware virtualizations, which can allow us to run two or more different operating systems to perform various tasks at the same time in a single unique system. That is known as hardware virtualization. Basically, the hardware virtualization having two things, namely host machine and a guest machine. The host machine is nothing but the host operating system machine. The guest machine is nothing but which can be generated virtualized machine. It can be generated as a virtualized machine. That is called as a guest machine. So once the virtualization environment is provided, then only we can able to creating various guest machines. So these two things are required in hardware virtualization environments. The software that can create a virtual machine and the host hardware is called hypervisor. As we said that, hypervisor is a software that is related to virtualization software. Hypervisor is a virtualization software which can be stored on top of the host operating system to provide an environment for creating any virtualization. So simply another name for hypervisor is VMM, that is called virtual machine manager. Virtual machine manager. Nowadays, the virtual machines are running with modern operating systems and processors, which can allow us to run multiple processes simultaneously at the same time. If sometimes we can see that systems make crash, the virtual machines or the systems or the servers make crash, that can be happened due to some reasons, some hardware failure reasons or some overloaded failure reasons. So most of the systems are virtual machines are failure or crash due to some technical reasons or some hardware failure reasons. This can be happened if there is no protection mechanism in a processor. So when the processor are working with more than one operation at the same time, there is a huge pressure on processors. So always the processors will be run with a well-maintained protection mechanism. So at that time, many instructions with different processors can access hardware components directly. So at that time, the protection mechanism will play a vital role for controlling the network for performing the task. If there is no protection mechanism in such processors, the instructions that are processing or accessing the available hardware directly which may cause the failure of the system or which may cause the destroy of the system. To overcome the problem, what we do, we need to provide a well-defined protection mechanism for each processor. So therefore, all processors have at least two modes. Every computer processor can have working in two different modes. One is user mode, another one is supervisor mode. That is called as a host mode, another one is a guest mode, administrative mode or guest mode. So technically we can call as a two modes. One is user mode, another one is supervisor mode. Control access of critical hardware, that means that installation of an hardware or remove the hardware, or we need to do some any updations on the hardware system. So the user, the end user having access to control various operations in two different modes. The first one is user mode, another one is supervisor mode. What is user mode? What is supervisor mode? We will discuss now. So instructions running in supervisor mode are called visualized instructions. So instructions means many jobs are running in a supervisor mode are called as a privileged mode instructions. Otherwise, simply we can call as a unprivileged instructions that can be done in user mode. So that means that always privileged instructions running in a supervisor mode and unprivileged instructions run in a user mode. So in a well-defined virtualized environment, it is very difficult to make operating systems and the applications run correctly over the available virtualized manner because there are more layers in the machine stack. So these more layers are required for providing an environment for the virtual machines. Let us consider a simple example. We can define the hardware operating virtualization concept with a simple example. Let us consider here Intel x86 processor. Intel is a software company. x86 is the server name. So the Intel company is generated one server, they are created one server with virtualization supported hardware. Hardware supported virtualization, how will be generated by Intel x86 processor, we will discuss here. Consider an Intel hardware support for virtualization of processors, memory, and input-output devices. So these are terms are considered as key elements of hardware support virtualization. Whenever you want to create hardware support for virtualization, these key elements are required. These three are considered as a hardware support virtualization elements, namely processors, memory, and input-output devices. So these considered as a hardware support virtualization that can provide an environment for various virtual machines. Here there are N virtual machines are kept in a virtual environment, namely virtual machine 0, virtual machine 1, virtual machine 2, and so on, virtual machine N. Each virtual machine having one host operating system and various application softwares are running in each and every virtual machine. So these virtual machines, these N number of virtual machines commonly sharing the resources of hardware support virtualization like processors, memory, and input-output devices. How this virtual machine will impact our hardware support virtualization, we will see. So in Intel x86 processor, for processors virtualization, Intel offers VTX or VTI. VT stands for virtualization technology. Virtualization technology, and X stands for x86 processor, or VT stands for virtualization technology, and I stands for another processor, Italian processor. That means that for Intel offers two processors, likely VTX or VTI. These two are virtual technologies. The VTX technology adds a privileged mode. It adds a privileged mode and some instructions to the processors. This enhanced traps all the sensitive instructions in the virtual machine monitor or virtual machine manager or hypervisor automatically. So here, coming to another element, hardware element like memory, Intel offers the EPT, which translates, what it will do, which translates virtual address to machine address. It can convert the virtual address to machine address, and machine address is converted into physical address to improve. So in machine memory, if you are working with memory, the Intel offers the EPT, which can translate, it can provide a mapping between virtual address to physical address and physical address to machine address, and we can provide a mapping between virtual address to physical address and physical address to main memory address, so through which we can able to effectively utilize the memory with the help of the page tables. Next, another key element of hardware device is input-output device. For input-output in virtualization, the Intel x86 processor implements VTD and VTC, virtual technology D and virtual technology C. These two are well-defined network and storage devices. So like that, hardware support virtualization in Intel x86 will perform various techniques and various modes. It can be operated for performing various tasks in a virtualized manner. So next we move to CPU virtualization. What is mean by CPU virtualization? So basically, CPU virtualization is nothing but central processing unit virtualization. So the effectiveness or the performance of any virtualization machine will be mainly depends on CPU virtualization. Why? Because if the CPU virtualization is running with huge amount of data with a huge speed in a limited time, so automatically the efficiency of CPU will be increased, due to which we can perform various tasks easily within a span of time without any failure. So a virtual machine is a duplicate of an existing computer machine in which majority of virtual machine instructions are executed on the host processor in a native mode. There are two modes always the machine will work. One is user mode, another one is privileged supervisor mode. Here, native mode is nothing but user mode. Thus, unprivileged instructions of any virtual machines run directly on host machine for higher efficiency. So basically, there are three categories the virtual CPU machines running, namely privileged instructions, control sensitive instructions, and behavior sensitive instructions. Here, privileged instructions means the executions in privileged mode. All the executions in CPU virtualization under this privileged instructions are to processing through a mode considered as a privileged mode, not a user mode. And all the instructions will be trapped if the execution outside of the mode. Coming to the point of control sensitive instructions. Here, there is a possibility of changing the configuration of resources used. Some of the resources we are used based on the requirement. Sometimes we need to do some modifications on the resources, like we need to schedule the CPU scheduling, we need to do modifications on the memory, modifications on the input-output devices, and the modifications of various CPU scheduling. So these changes, configurations are required based on the required performing machines higher efficiency. Another one is behavior sensitive instructions. These have different behaviors depending on the configuration of resources, including the load and store operations over virtual machines. So the load can be performed using load balancing, and the store operations can be performed by adding huge number of stacks of servers to the existing virtualization concepts. So these can be lead to the behavior change of instructions, can be controlled through load balancing and stacks of servers. So some of well familiar CPU virtualizations which are listed here, there are four different virtualization CPUs, namely software based, hardware assisted, processor specific behavior, and finally performance amplifications. Here, consider the first one is software based CPU virtualization. It is considered as a hypervisor. The best example is a hypervisor. Hypervisor is a software based CPU virtualization which can be provides an environment for creating any virtual machine over the physical machine. Whereas hardware assisted CPU virtualizations are a machines in which the hardware elements like the memory, the CPU and input output hardware elements can be controlled. This can be shared the resources over the CPU virtualizations. And the processor specific behavior CPU virtualization is nothing but the load on processor and the storage capacity on the processor may be vary from one situation to another situations based on the situations. So it may automatically increase their capacity with the help of the CPU virtualizations. And always the effective performance and the effective utilizations of virtualization concepts will be mainly deals with the performance implications. Why CPU virtualization is important? The CPU virtualization is important because it can lead the performance and efficiency, the overall performance and efficiency of any CPU, any virtualizations can be improved because of CPU virtualization only. With the help of CPU virtualization, the virtual machines to work on a single CPU but sharing resources like various processors or various memory or various input output devices at the same time, due to which we can save the money and the cost. Why? Because if we want to purchase the hardware virtualization components, it is very costlier. To overcome the problem, our CPU is simply sharing the resources of all hardware virtualizations which can be supported. For this, we can save a lot of cost and money. So that's why we can consider CPU virtualization is more important nowadays for creating the virtualization. Next, as we said, another virtualization concept model is hardware assisted CPU virtualization. Here, let us consider a simple example of Intel CPU virtualization, how it will impact on hardware assisted CPU virtualization. Here, consider a virtual machine. The virtual machine is considered as a Intel VTX technology. So this is an example of Intel VTX technology. VTX stands for virtual technology. X is the x86 server capacity. So Intel VTX technology is an example for hardware assisted virtualization. Here VTX stands for Intel virtual technology used for x86 processors. So here Intel calls the privileged level of x86 processors on VMX root mode. In order to control the start VM entry and stop VM exit of a virtual machine and allocate memory pages to maintain CPU state for virtual machines and allocate memory for the various virtual machines, a set of additional instructions is to be added for VMX. At the time of this, then Intel Gen VMware and the Microsoft Virtual PC all implements their virtual machines hypervisors using VTX technology. So here various processors running, two different processors are running. One is VTX, is one of the virtual technology Xeon server. Another one is virtual technology. So I is another server. These two servers are running. These two servers are maintaining virtual machines control structures, and they can configuring the virtual machine over the VMX root modes. So the virtual machine start and the virtual machine exit can also performed by controlling or configuring virtual machine controlling system. A well-established virtual machine configuration system, due to which we can able to control the entry or exit. That means that the start of virtual machine and the stop of virtual machine can be done with the help of these VMCS. Here, the VMCS virtual machine configuration systems can control the virtual machines running over here. Here, two different virtual machines running. One is VM0, another one is VM0. So these are having virtual modes. These are having application softwares and one operating system like Windows X, So these virtual machine can be start and can be stopped. These configurations can be well familiar controlled by one of the virtual machine configuration system with the help of available two processes. So that's why the hardware assisted CPU utilization is very familiar for controlling the various virtual machines based on the requirement. So next we move to another key element is memory. In hardware, another key element is memory. So how memory will impact in virtualization, we will discuss now. So memory virtualization means we can remember here two concepts. So what is physical memory? What is physical address? What is virtual memory? What is virtual address? What is machine memory and what is machine address? We will let you know before discussing about memory virtualization. And also here we can focus on one concept that is called as a page table. Page table. A page table is a data structure used by the virtual memory system to store the mapping between virtual logic address and physical address. So in a traditional execution environment, operating systems maintains mapping of virtual memory between machine memory using page tables, which is one stage mapping from virtual memory to virtual machine memory. Suppose, for example, let us consider an example here, how a memory virtualization will play an important role. Now we will discuss it. Here, consider a page table. A page table is a data structure. Page table is a data structure used by virtual memory system. This can be used by virtual memory system. That is called as a VMM. Another name for VMM is hypervisor. Store a mapping between virtual logical address and physical address. This is virtual logical address and virtual physical address. So the page table will provide an environment for mapping between virtual address and physical address over the network. That can be done by the help of page table or VMM, virtual memory management, or virtual memory automation. So here, consider that a CPU, central processing unit, and a page table and a memory. So here in this page tables, there are n number of pages. So page 0, P0, P1 up to P-1, M number of pages. Here memory, M0, M1 up to N-1, N number of memories. So these are page tables, these are memory tables. And here the CPU. The CPU can run with different operating systems, different processors, central processing units. So whenever the CPU is working with different operating systems and different processors, so the CPU can well connected to the RAM, random access memory. What is RAM? Which type of memory will store in the RAM? Always the physical memory stored in your RAM. The physical memory will be stored in your RAM. So the RAM will be maintain the data temporarily. When the system will shut down, automatically the data will be not stored permanently, but always the data will be stored in a virtual memory only. So here the virtual or logical address are generated by CPU. The virtual address or another name is logical address, which can be generated by the CPU for pages of processes. Here the physical address are the actual frame address of the memory. Here the page table is a data structure used by virtual memory or virtual address store or provide the mapping between virtual address and physical address. So here consider that there are two different virtual machines running with more than one processors at the same time. So here there are three different memories and each memory is having their virtual address. Virtual memory, this is virtual memory or virtual address, and these two are physical memories or physical address, and this is finally machine memory or machine address. Finally, the data will be stored permanently in the machine address only or machine memory only. So whenever the CPU will interact with the physical machine, so it can be stored the physical address or virtual address temporarily, and it can move to the physical address. It's called as a RAM, and after that, so it can be mapped to the machine address or machine memory. So finally, here the physical memory and the virtual memory will provide a map between CPU and memory management. So here the physical memory refers to the actual RAM of the system, stores the currently executed programs, whereas the virtual memory is the memory management technique that allows the users to execute programs larger than the actual physical memory. Best example, we have seen this type of memory virtualization in workstations or servers or modern personal computers. We will see this type of virtualizations. Here the address is translated from one virtual address to physical address through one operating system that is called as a page table. And finally, so here the consolidated page table data will be permanently stored into the disk once it can be confirmed or it can be well mapped with the memory. So next we move to another key element, memory virtualization. In this memory virtualization, a two-stage mapping process should be maintained by the guest operating system and the virtual machine manager respectively, like virtual memory or physical memory and physical memory to machine memory. So these are two stages. So how to map or virtual to physical to virtual, we already discussed in last slide. Here a mapping between virtual address and physical address that can be done through one VM, that is called a virtual machine or hypervisor. But the guest operating system cannot directly having the access to the machine memory. Here the virtual machine management is responsible for mapping the guest physical address and the actual memory address. So the last component or the last key element of the hardware component is input-output devices. Let us see what is input-output virtualization. So this type of input-output virtualization involves managing the routing of input-output requests between virtual devices and shared physical hardware devices. There are three ways to implement input-output virtualization, like full device emulation, para virtualization, and direct input-output virtualization. In full device emulation, so there is a host operating system. There is no need or there is no updation or no change of operating system. But in para virtualization, we are used updated operating system with a guest operating system. So here the performance of full device emulation is very high and it is having less security, whereas the para virtualization is low efficiency and the security is more compared to the full device emulation. And coming to the third one is direct input output virtualization. In the direct input output virtualization, this is we can attach to many routing technologies, I mean, many routing concepts. So for providing the internet or intranet services over the period of time. Next, we discuss about virtualization in multi-core processes. What is multi-core? Multi-core processor is nothing but the system or the machine is running with two or more core processors in the same machine at the same time. Providing a virtualization concept is called as a multi-core processors. This type of multi-core processor virtualizing is more complicated than uni-core processors. Why? Because the efficiency is more, running with more than one core processor at the time. So by using multi-core processors, higher performance of the systems can get controlled with multiple processors in a single operating system with the single chip. And the multiple core virtualization has raised some new challenges to computer architects, compiler constructors, or the design of the systems and the application programs. There are two difficulties when we use multi-core processors. The first one is application programs must be parallelized to use all cores fully. And the other one is software must be explicitly assigned tasks to the cores when very complex problem. Let us consider the multi-core architecture with a simple Intel server. Here, if you consider the graph, the top portion of the graph is having many shaded, fully shaded, some are partial shaded, some are not shaded. These are clusters. And each one is considered as a cluster. There are lot of clusters. And these clusters are divided into 8 different clusters or 8 different virtual machines over placed here. So the virtual machines, namely VM0, VM1, VM2, VM3, VM4, VM5, VM6, VM7. There are eight different virtual machines are placed over here. These are considered as a clusters, and the same type of virtual machines are kept into a cluster. So total 8 different clusters are framed here. This is cluster 1, partially shaded, and this is another cluster, cluster 2, like a L-shaped. This is not shaded cluster, and other one is, this is third cluster. So this is fully shaded cluster, block cluster. Another one is little bit shaded cluster, this is another cluster. And this is another cluster, these 4 also another cluster. Total 8 different clusters running with different virtual machines likely. So here, 2 virtual machines, namely virtual machine 0, virtual machine 3, are running with database virtual machine clusters. And 2 more virtual machines, namely 1 virtual machine 1, virtual machines 2, are considered as a web server machines. And rest of 4 virtual machines, namely virtual machine 4, 5, 6, 7, are considered as a middleware servers. So consider here, this is a simple virtual machine. The virtual machine run with a cache data and a processor and also some other input-output devices. So various hardware, memory, processor, and CPU all are kept in each and every virtual machine. So the virtual hierarchy is, consider the virtual hierarchy, each virtual hierarchy is a cache hierarchy that can adapt to fit the workload or mix of workloads here. The hierarchy first level locates data blocks. First level, this is the first level of the hierarchy, virtual hierarchy. So this locates data blocks, various data blocks here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 different data blocks which are closely located to the cores needing them for faster access or establishes a shaded cache domain and establish a point of coherence for faster communication. When a miss leaves a tile, it was attempting to locate the block within the first level. The first level can also provide isolation between independent workloads. There is a well-connected isolation between independent clusters. Here, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 different independent workloads. Each workload is assigned for a cluster. So suppose L1 cache can invoke the L2, L1 cache invoke the L2 access. For example, here, these are well connected to the level 2 based on the requirement only. So multiple virtual clusters assigned to various workloads. So based on the CPU virtualization, CPU scheduling, CPU load, the mapping of virtualizations to be done with the different core virtual machines. Here the figure 2, this one seems to be the logical view of such virtual cluster hierarchy in two levels, like level 2 and level 1. Level 1 is the various workloads which can be performed with the help of, which can be categorized into 8 different categories with the help of clusters. These are well connected to another layer, layer 2. So here in this layer, we can install one software that is called as a hypervisor software. With the help of the hypervisor software, so various virtual machines, it can provide one virtual environment over there. In that virtual environment, we can able to create different types of virtual machines, like virtual machine 0 to virtual machine 7. Total 7 different virtual machines can be created, can be effectively performed with the help of the virtual environment, with the help of the one software that is called CEMVMM, Virtual Machine Manager or Hypervisor. So we have been discussed in this session, online session, how virtualization hardware will impact with the different keys, different elements like CPU virtualization and memory virtualization, input-output virtualization, how this will impact with multi-core virtualization concepts also we will discuss today in this session. So now I am closing the session. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.